In today's show, I'm going to give you a lot more information so what are the really vitamins, what vitamins do in our body, and especially what kind of vitamins you really need to use. This is very important information, important video for everyone that wants to learn a lot more about vitamins. Vitamins are essential to life. They contribute to good health by regulating the metabolism and assisting to biochemical processes that release energy from digested food. They are considered micronutrients because the body needs them in relatively small amounts compared with the nutrients such as carbohydrates, proteins, fats, and water. Enzymes are essential chemicals that are foundation of the human bodily functions. They are catalysts, activators in the chemical reaction that are continually taking place with the body. As coenzymes, the vitamins work with enzymes, thereby allowing all the activities that are occurring with the body to be carried out as they should be. Whole, fresh, raw foods are a good source of vitamin and enzymes. What also you really need to know about the vitamins? Vitamins, we can make them into two special groups. One of group is vitamin that are soluble in water. Other groups is vitamin soluble in the fats or in the oils. Water-soluble vitamins must be taken into the body daily, as they cannot be stored and excreted within 4 hours to 1 day. Those include vitamin C and the B complex vitamins. Oil-soluble vitamins can be stored for longer periods of time in the body, fatty tissues, and the liver. These include vitamins A, D, E, and K. Both types of vitamins are needed by the body for the proper function. Synthetic versus natural vitamins, this is also a very good question. Make sure you're getting at least 100% of all essential vitamins from the food you eat within a diet rich in fruits and vegetables. This is also very important when we think about the vitamins. Usually, when you eat good quality food that had a lot of good vitamins, this is the best way for you to get healthy. Second most important information is you can take also vitamins as a supplements, but those supplements must be in a great quality. When we think about it, once this has been accomplished, most people, we need more from supplements to achieve optimum health. Vitamin supplements can be divided into two groups, synthetic and natural. Synthetic vitamins are produced in laboratories from isolated chemicals that mirror their counterparts found in the nature. Natural vitamins are derived from the food sources, although there are no major chemical differences between a vitamin found in the food and one created in the laboratory. Synthetic supplements contain the isolated vitamins only, while natural supplements may contain other nutrients not yet discovered. This is because the vitamins are in their natural state. If you are deficient in particular nutrient, the chemical source will work, but you will not get the benefits of vitamin as found in whole foods. Supplements that are not labeled natural also maybe include coal tars, artificial coloring, preservatives, sugars, and the starch, as well as other additives. That is one of most important things that you really need to know. As I say to my patients, sometimes I said it on my channel, when you take into considerations like 100% of vitamin supplements in the world, I would suggest and tell you 90-95% are not good quality. And not good quality supplements cannot help you, and that is what you really need to know. That's why you really need to take in consideration to buy good quality supplements that only can help you a lot. You should be aware of such harmful elements. However, you should also note that bottle of natural vitamins might contain vitamins that have not been extracted from natural food source. It is necessary to read labels carefully to make sure the products you buy contain nutrients from food sources we know of artificial additives mentioned above. Studies have shown that protein-bound vitamins, as found in natural whole food supplements, are absorbed, utilized, and retained in the tissue better than supplements that are not protein-bounded. Chemical-derived vitamins are not protein-bounded. Vitamins and minerals in the food are bonded to the proteins, lipids, carbohydrates, and the bioflavonoids. Taking supplements with meals helps to assure supply of other nutrients needed for better assimilation as well. And one also a very good recommendations, most of the vitamin supplements that you'll be taking, take them with the food. Some of them you will take it on the empty stomach, but everything that you need to know about to how to take especially supplements is going to be on the label. But usually very good information is that you take your vitamins with the food. Also, what is on the shelves? Over-the-counter vitamin supplements come in various forms, combinations and amounts. They are available in the tablet, capsules, gel capsule, powder, some linger under the tongue, lozenge, nanoparticles and liquid forms. They can also be administered by injection. In the most cases, it is a matter of personal preferences as how you take them. However, due to slight variation in how rapidly the supplements are absorbed and assimilated in the body, we will sometimes recommend it one form over another. Vitamin supplements are usually available as isolated vitamins or in combination with other nutrients. It is important to select your vitamins based upon your real need. If you find one supplement that meets your needs, remember to take it daily. If it does not contain a large enough quantity of what you want, you may consider taking more of that one. Just make sure that you are aware of increased dosage of the other nutrients it may contain. I want to give you a couple more very important information. Usually, when you take water-soluble vitamins, take them after the meal or after you eat, but if you take oil or vitamins that is soluble in oils or in fats, take them before meal. So vitamin that's soluble in oil before meal, in the water after the meal. Also, when you purchase good quality vitamin supplements, you store them in the dark, cool place, especially in your house. But for today's show, it's what is more important. Vitamins is crucial for our health. Always take good quality food, but it's also important. This is also what I was reading in my first book that is called Intermittent Fasting: Secrets on the Health and Longevity. You must always take a good quality diet with good quality foods, and that your inquirements about nutrition is going to help you a lot. If you take vitamin supplements, it must be good quality, and this is also very important. What else you really need to know about vitamin D deficiency, you can find here on this video. Thank you for following me. See you next time. Bye bye.